Very good morning, all. Myself, Dr. Ansar Ahmed, and today I'm going to talk about flip-flop. In the previous lecture, we discussed about latch, which is very important part of flip-flop. And actually, what is the difference between latch and flip-flop? We will see in this one, and then we will go for different type of flip-flop. So in this one, first of all, let me define what is flip-flop. In sequential circuit, sequential circuit, I think no need to explain. Circuits which have in which output depends on present input as well as previous output. So in sequential circuit, a storage device or we can call memory is required to know what exactly has happened in the past. So as we have seen in the previous definition of a sequential circuit, these are the input and these are the outputs, and outputs are fed back to the inputs. Okay, so this by which the output is fed back to the input, it is stored temporary, and that is called memory, which store bits or data, memory. Okay, so in sequential circuit, a storage device is required to know what exactly has happened in the past. So what happened in the past, that is kept or stored for the reference. The basic unit of such a storage device is known as flip-flop. So what happened at the output previously, it is kept in that storage. Okay, so a flip-flop is a memory device that has clock signal to change control the state of the device. So what is flip-flop? Flip-flop is a memory device that has clock signal to change or to control the state of the device. Okay, so whatever is stored here, that is called flip-flop with a clock. What is clock? Already we have seen this is a waveform at which signal change its state. Okay, flip-flops are usually an application of logic gates. Okay, so flip-flop may be an application of logic gates. Flip-flops can also be considered as the most basic idea of random access memory. Okay, so this is an idea for a random access memory, without which a computer can't be imagined. A higher application of flip-flop is helpful in designing better electronic circuit. So whatever electronic circuits we design for delicate things or to handle in better way, that circuits of course have memories. The most commonly used application of flip-flop is in the implementation of feedback circuit. Why we need feedback circuits? Because many times we want to make things better or want to count the things. Okay, suppose this is one, then two. So there are a lot of places where we need to store the state. Okay, and of course to improve the quality or the things that what happened in the previously. So after observing that previous things, we can increase, decrease, or whatever we want from the circuits. As a memory relies on the feedback concept, flip-flop can be used to design them. So, as a memory relies on the feedback concept, flip-flop can be used to design them. Okay, so it's a basic memory element which store 1 bits. So suppose this is the data which we want to store. So 1 bit store actually one flip-flop store only 1 bit. So 4 bits required, four flip-flop to store the 1 1 4 flip-flop to store 1 1 0 1. Okay, so whatever number or digits we have as per the number of digits, we need flip-flop, because one flip-flop store 1 bit only. We studied latch also, so let's find out what is the basic difference between the latch and flip-flop, because many times latch may be recalled as the flip-flop. Okay, so what it means, basic principle of latch, it follows level triggering. Already we know many types of triggering, that is which is able to change the state of the circuit. So we have many type of triggering, like level triggering or edge triggering. So latch triggering so latch uses level triggering, that is this is the waveform. This is the waveform and this is the level. This is positive level and this is the negative level. So latch uses level triggering, that is the state will be changed only at this level, either high level or low level. Flip-flop utilize edge triggering approach. So this is a major difference. In fact, this is the basic one also. You can identify it, which one is latch, which is memory. So this is the positive edge triggering, when the waveform is going from 0 to 1 and this is 1 to 0. Okay, so this is 0 to 1 or 1 to 0. So this is a edge triggering design using. So how they are designed? They are designed by using logic gates. As we have seen that using NOR gate, NAND gate, we made the latches. Okay, while flip-flop are designed using latches with a clock. We will see that RS flip-flop or D flip-flop, they are used latches for its designing. Okay, clock signals. Very important difference between the latch and flip-flop is it does not use any clock, no clock. Clock is present, it is very important. This is also basic difference. If there is no clock, then it means this is latch. Okay, and if this is clock, then it means it uses, if there is a clock, then it means this is flip-flop. Sensitivity means how much circuit is sensitive for the output. It is sensitive to applied input signal when enabled. Okay, so it is sensitive to applied input signal when enabled. As soon as we applied the inputs, then output change. But what happened in flip-flop? It is sensitive to applied input signal with clock signal. Until and unless we will not apply clock signal, then output will not be there. So there be no change in the output until and unless we applied clock at input. So this is also important difference. Power requirement in latches is less, because of course one factor, clock is not there, while flip-flop uses more power. Let's see some other differences also. Operating speed, Operating speed is fast in latches. Flip-flop has a little bit slow speed. Okay, latches actually, why they are fast? Because they are asynchronous in nature. That is, they need not wait to apply clock on the inputs to change the outputs. Okay, so these two points are related to each other. These two points are related to each other. Okay, so this one and this one, there is slow because clock pulse is applied. Okay, so when we apply, we will apply clock pulse, then it, then the output will change. While there is no time to wait for the clock. Circuit analysis is complex, somewhat quite easy, because it is somewhere made up of it. Robustness, this is less robust because sometime it become unstable because of the asynchronous mode. That is comparatively more stable because we get output on the present of the clock only. So this is stable in nature, and that's why it is related to the robustness. Uses as a register. Okay, so when we will see the application of latches and flip-flop in register, which store the bits, of course, registers which store the data, or where we store the data, they are called registers. So latches does not support for the register, to the registers, while flip-flop supported to the register. I mean, flip-flop is the basic building block for storing the data, that is for registers. Okay, so it was the main difference between the flip-flop and latches. So guys, please don't forget, though you can say flip-flop, but when you know the basic difference, that what is latch or what is flip-flop, so it is a triggering, a level triggering latches uses, while flip-flop uses edge triggering, and both have their own plus and negatives. Other than this one, that is, clock is very important difference between the latch and flip-flop. Latch use no clock, while flip-flop uses clock. This is very important. So by two or three difference, you can identify which one is latch and which one is flip-flop. And then types of flip-flop. So we just came to know what is flip-flop. This is a memory storage device. How many type of flip-flops we have in general? So we have four type of flip-flop: SR flip-flop, SR flip-flop, JK flip-flop, D flip-flop, T flip-flop. So these are the general flip-flops, and of course the entire unit of third unit is related to these all flip-flop. So in the next lecture, we will design what is SR flip-flop and how it works, then JK flip-flop, D flip-flop, then T flip-flop. So if you are able to identify, to understand SR flip-flop, then you can understand JK flip-flop, D flip-flop, T flip-flop. Okay, so there is no issue. I am trying to make it easy and understandable for everything, for everyone. So guys, it was all about the flip-flop. In the next lecture, we will discuss some other thing, that is designing of SR flip-flop, clocked SR flip-flop, because already we have discussed about SR latch, and if you understand latch, then you will be able to understand the SR flip-flop. So whatever you know about the latch, you will apply to the SR flip-flop. If you don't understand latch, which is the basic building block for the flip-flop, then you cannot understand the SR flip-flop. So try to get SR latch and how it works, and then what is the truth table for it. Okay, so guys, for today it's we end here. In the next lecture we'll discuss. Till then, have a great time.